Help you folks. Name's Randolph.
Hello everybody, DarkPhoenix Ninja 92 here, and welcome back to Let's Play Alan Wake. Last time we left off, that asshole who kidnapped Alan's wife is blackmailing us for a manuscript that's not done yet. And apparently that creepy stalker girl has found some pages from said manuscript. So we have to go and get it. Though I have to admit, she still creeps me the hell out. And if you're wondering why I'm talking over Barry when I usually shut up for people's conversations, it's because this was in the last episode. So if you have been watching these in order and haven't just jumped in just now, you'll have already seen this stuff. And I seem to have done a relatively okay job of stabilizing the recording frame rate. It's still significantly below what is being what the game's actually playing at, as I babble for a moment, but it's better than it was last time, and I'm going to keep at it, but who knows. In any case, it's time to go. We have a conversation to check out, and did my settings get screwed with somewhere? None of the graphics settings are off, that's for sure. And I almost screwed with them myself. I'm kind of out of it as far as the controls go. And a bunch of other things. I've literally not played Alan Wake since before my last episode of it went up. In fact, I think it was sometime around last May or something, or actually probably last March that I played this game. So I'm gonna be a little out of it for this session, probably, but I really wanted to get back into it. Because it's been ages since I recorded anything, for a variety of reasons that some recent update videos will have informed you of if you watched them. But yeah, I really like this game.
It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky.
And what the hell?
But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers.
Yeesh. That is lucky, yeah. And yes, I am following you, Mr. Randolph. Right now, I just... I really need to remember that I'm supposed to be deactivating my Steam overlay or whatever.
They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook store. The scratching hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia
Weaver.
You
say that name like I should know it.
And she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or anything.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane.
Oh great, a bunch of horror stories written by an insane nut job. That's just what we need. Don't we already have enough problems with a psychopath blackmailing us for a manuscript for some unknown reason? Said psychopath, who I'm fairly certain was in Alan's dream at the beginning of the game, and virtually unkillable. So,
well, mister,
we are not
Rose's trailer.
In a good place.
You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
Yeah, no. Let's get this over with. Because if she's as insane a fangirl as she seemed, then
welcome to
this could be
to
a problem.
Oh dear. Mr. Wake, I'm so glad you're here.
What's...
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh. Oh, yes. Yes. Please,
okay.
Come in.
I can't be the only one who's hearing this. it sounds like she's some sort of robot or drone.
Rose,
I am hearing stereotypical mind control voice.
I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry? She doesn't have anything.
Yeah, hey, Al? Al, what's...
We've been drugged. We've been fucking drugged.
Barry. What?
I am going to hurt you. Badly. I do not like you, lady. And I am going to make you suffer for this. And smile while I do it.
Hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn
what
the lights on.
The actual fuck. What the actual fuck is going on here?
Lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
What the hell?
You must turn the lights on. Turn the light on.
Ugh, I swear. Nothing in here makes sense anymore. What is going on? I would really like to know.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
You're damn right.
I can't tell reality from
I am
anymore,
going to find
Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive, and each day there's less of me and more of her. I hate it, but I know she's right.
I am going to hurt her badly. But we may as well take the coffee.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me and left its mark.
Wait, what?
First refill is free. Milk
yes, I'm hearing mind control voice.
Would you like to hear today's specials?
But seriously, that monotone, dull voice is
Barry was out.
Creepier than any of those shadow men jumping out at me in the entire previous bit of the game that I've played. Somehow, this monotone voice girl manages to creep me out more than them. And that is a damn achievement.
I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
A manuscript page. Get the car, huh? Well, according to the game, I guess we are leaving Barry's ass here. And the missing gun and flashlight are going to be a problem because... when we get jumped by these things, and you know it's fucking going to happen, we are not going to be able to kill them, and are just going to have to run like a chicken with our head cut off. And I am not looking forward to this. I swear, this game is creepy as fuck sometimes. And as much as I am a masochist about things like this, and deliberately choose to play these types of games, it's still fucking scary when that shit happens, especially when you can't do anything about it. What the hell?
God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI! Get him up, Hemingway! You're under arrest! You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face! Stay right where you are,
I am going to hurt you. You assholes had better pray I don't manage to get myself a fat man or something. Because you
I'm
would
standing right here, you goddamn maniac.
You would make excellent target practice for a mini nuke launcher.
But there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnappers.
And now we have to escape from the cops. Lovely. Why does this shit always happen to me? Why couldn't it just be stroll in, get the manuscript, and get out? why did we have to end up in a damn cop chase? Really? A cop chase? What the hell? You people might be the law, but you're also a bunch of self-absorbed jackasses that I do not like in any way, shape, or form. Go fuck yourselves, seriously.
Damn.
And they've caught up to us. God damn it. How about you stop shooting me and actually do something productive with your lives? Don't you know I'm the protagonist, and therefore your efforts are doomed to failure? And I don't care that I'm using video game logic. So don't even freaking bring it up. But come on, run, run, run. God damn it, Alan, you have the worst stamina in the history of anything.
Come on, guys. We need to head him off.
How about not? There's another manuscript page. We're making progress. But I was hoping that you'd be able to grab it from this lady. Too much to hope, I suppose. Oh, Jesus. I have a very bad feeling about this. Is someone bitching at them because they shot at us? I guess so. Excessive force and all that jazz. But we have a meeting to get to and some cops to run the hell away from, so I can't dwell too much on that subject, I'm afraid. And you've probably noticed this by now, but you are still going to be hearing the sound of me pressing keyboard buttons in the recording, because I have yet to figure out what I can do about that, and I don't exactly have the budget for a new microphone right now, so I'm not going to be able to just buy a new mic so that I can avoid having to use this one. This way.
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Oh great, we are in clusterfuck land again. And like I was saying, yeah, you'll be hearing me pressing buttons on my keyboard, keys on my keyboard. As I run the hell away.
Hold it right there.
Because I don't really have the budget to get a microphone or extension arm or other hardware that I can set up in the kind of way I would need to not have it be recorded by my microphone. And I'm not sure what kind of editing I can do on this. Because I'm not really the best when it comes to sound editing, so I'm afraid you're just going to have to put up with it for now. And let's use this thing and just have a look. Something is burning over there. I don't know, I have a very bad feeling about this. But we have a checkpoint, and checkpoints are good, right? In here, though. Coffee thermos, and what the hell is that? I don't know what I just did, but oh well. I don't know what's going on. But I don't like it either.
We got Wheeler and Rose here. Wheeler's dropped or hopped up on something. Speaking of which, that fed had a pretty distinctive whiff of all the scotch about it, you know what I mean? Over. I don't have anything on that, Deputy Mulligan. Over.
Okay.
Well, whatever. Anyway, Rose is just being
what are we supposed to be doing now? That's what I want to know.
Over. Gotcha. You better get them here quickly. The Fed's gonna want to interview Wheeler. Over. Oh, yeah.
Maybe I don't actually need to go up there. That seems about right. Yeah. Maybe I didn't need to be running up there.
I imagine that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station.
Okay.
Main seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
And we are going to be in what I like to call
shadows clung to the gate.
The hell away land.
I wouldn't get through without a light.
A light? Where the hell am I supposed to get one of those from? And I died. Not really sure what I'm supposed to be doing here.
This is Jane.
Okay. What do I do now? That's what I'm wondering. Okay. We need a light, apparently, but I'm not seeing one.
I imagine that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Main seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
And then we have this shit.
Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light.
And where am I supposed to find a light at? That's what I would like to know.
There was no power to the searchlight.
Okay. Now, what can I do about that? Let's go back in here. But apparently, I need to destroy this gate to proceed. What have we got that I can use? I am going to need something, but I don't know what.
I could see the lights at the radio station in the distance.
I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing, honestly. Not the best recording session so far, is it? Seeing as I haven't the slightest clue what I do. And we have a magical possessed gate keeping us out. Not the best situation to find yourself in, I have to admit. I'm seeing some coffee thermoses, but no lights. Oh. Start the generator, maybe. And I guess this is our way in. Wasn't really doing that right, I suppose.
The old generator conked out. I'd have to see if I could fix it and try again.
Okay. Now, how do I fix it? ticket. And start it again. So, a little bit of rinse and repeat, I suppose. And goodbye, gate. So, we have our path again. That's nice. Time to keep going and probably get jumped by shadow monsters, knowing my luck. But we'll do it anyways and hope that we don't die too many times. Oh, great. But there's a flashlight at least. Finally, we have a flashlight again. Now all we need is a gun. And then we'll be back to actually being able to fight these things.
It took me a moment to recognize the flashbangs. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Yes, flashbangs. Grab them. Ugh, what's going on with these people? But flashbangs can use against these guys. And run like the devil is after us, which he might as well be considering our situation. But, oh sweet Jesus, it's those things. Now, how about you not die, Alan? That would be grand. And we can stay safe in the light for now. Pick up some flashbangs. Turn that thing on.
You're on KBFFM with Pat Main.
It's Milt Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Milt?
Okay. Keep on going. And we have bad guys. A lot of them. But the flashbang is a divine gift, basically, at this point. But we're still dead. I can't say I'm all that surprised. I tend to die a lot in video games, as a lot of people will probably be able to tell you by now. And you will definitely know that I die a lot in games if you watch my Assassin's Creed playthrough. Let me put it this way. I died more in a single battle in that game than my entire playthrough when I wasn't recording it. So I'm convinced that I die more when I let's play than when I don't. Which I probably do, actually. It's not all that much of a surprise, because I have to split my focus, basically, between commentary and playing, which means I play worse. Now, come on, come on. We gotta get out of here, and we have shadow monsters after us, as well as the fucking police. Seriously, this has got to be one of the worst days ever. I mean, we have flashbangs, but we have a finite number of them. And I don't like having a finite number of the thing that we're basically relying on to save our asses. It tends to make me rather paranoid. Justifiably paranoid, but paranoid all the same. And now we have an even more finite number of them. Which makes me more paranoid. And that's going to keep on happening. Okay, we have a radio station here.
That we're about to reach. I hope Ming could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
I don't think this is going to go too well for us, honestly. He's probably going to think we're a criminal and want to murder us. Or turn us into the cops. That would not surprise me. Battery's going to be dead and try and slaughter us. Because he's one of those things now. Do we have to wait on him to finish?
Oh, here's a little surprise. The famous writer Alan Wake just walked
in. Oh, lovely.
I can talk him into an interview.
Come okay, on, thanks.
Wake. Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
What the hell?
You back away from me! Don't hurt!
Whoa, everyone calm down.
Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him.
What the hell's the matter with you?
There's a civilian in there.
That and you're shooting at me when I haven't done anything. So how about you cool it? I mean, I'm a writer and an American. Do the math.
I had fallen off so many cliffs, it's ridiculous.
If any,
what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine.
Yeah, as I was about to say, we are a writer and an American and we have money. That means basically we are going to sue them for everything under the sun. So, I hope they have disposable income because those assholes are paying for Alan's next vacation. If I have anything to say about it. And a revolver. Shotgun ammo? Well, we have to head to the train depot now. Oh, shit. And I just died. To nobody's surprise. But it's a decent checkpoint at least. So that's fairly nice. But we have no grenades. Cut it out, jackass. How the freaking hell did I manage that? Not even noticing that guy had already been exposed. Major fail on my part.